नमः पूर्णमिदं पूर्णात् पूर्णमुदच्यते पूर्णस्य पूर्णमादाय पूर्णमेवावशिष्यते। ॐ शांति शांति शांति। गुण विशिष्ट प्राण उपासना, उपासना ऑफ द प्राण विच इज इंडोर्ड विद सर्टेन क्वालिटीज। व्हाट वर द क्वालिटीज? विशुद्धत्वम, दूरत्वम, पुष्टिकरत्वम, अंगिरसत्वम, वाक्पतित्वम, ऑल दीज वेर द क्वालिटीज ऑफ द प्राण। दिस प्राण इज समष्टि क्रिया शक्ति विच परवेड्स ऑल, एंड वी हैव टू डू द उपासना। वाई वी हैव टू डू द उपासना? टू डिस आइडेंटिफाई विद द स्मॉल and identify with the bigger. Upasana, yesterday you heard the meaning of upasana. Up means near, asana means chintanam, sitting. Bhashyakar has written asanam means chintanam. So bringing the same topic, what you want to become in life, bringing it again and again in the mind, so that as I am very confirmed that I am a human being, I am a man, similarly that confirmation is there, I am the whole. I am the whole. I am not one human being, I am in all. I am all. So this is called the upasana of the Virat by the alamban of prana. So lot of gunas are mentioned. Yesterday you saw that in the speech also he is there. You heard he is the ras of all also. He nourishes all also. So we have to see that one everywhere. More a person has done upasana, more his mind will remain unaffected by personal joys and sorrows, because he won't feel it. He won't feel the joy and sorrow inflicted at a personal level, because he is not identified with that body. Ego means the over-identification with the small. You know, one word is called, he became over-conscious. In the debate, etc., you say he became over-conscious, he couldn't speak. Or somewhere we become over-conscious. What is the meaning of over-conscious? That at times we become forgetful of the higher self, and we over-remember our smallness and cut ourselves from the higher self. Okay, somebody was asking one day, supposing in action somebody has confidence, I'm confident I'll do this. How do we know this is a ego or this is not a ego? I said, when you feel that what work I have taken, it is so noble that God's strength is behind me, this is called confidence coming from God. And when you feel this work I alone can do, you don't remember the God's strength and don't do without praying to bring His power in you, this is called confidence of the ego. Only problem is, confidence of the ego is breakable, but confidence through the God is not breakable. Even if a person fails in doing God's work, he will feel, I'll again try, someday it will happen behind me. Because my intention is very noble, and definitely one day I will, like this squirrel who was helping in making the bridge for Bhagwan Ram. So this squirrel never felt small. So when you don't have the inferiority complex of being small in comparison to somebody. I see somebody very rich. I am an average middle class person. Because of the importance of money, I felt inferior. Not that I had less money, therefore I felt inferior. So I felt he has more money, therefore he is bigger. I have lesser money, therefore I am not that big. So the confidence that comes from remembering the Virat or remembering the Hiranyagarbha, that is called Kripabal. And supposing you are a qualified person, and you have good educational qualification, or you have qualities, you have gunas, so that is called Ahankar Bal. And in Sundar Kand, this is very well depicted. All the monkeys along with Hanumanji went to search for Sitaji, but they could not get, they got tired. Monkeys got tired, Angad ji got tired, and they gave up. Ultimately they said, we can't do anything. But someone who did not get tired was Sri Hanumanji. He did not get tired because he never felt that I alone have to do it. The person with Ahankar Bal gets tired when he gets defeated. He has nothing to hold on to, nothing to fall back upon. He is very excited. Ahankari person, he tries to do the work with lot of tenacity, lot of sincerity, lot of commitment. He's a very tough taskmaster. But when results don't come as he wants, which will not come all the time, he will break. And then people say such words, he has lost his confidence, or I am losing my confidence. Why you had finite confidence that you are losing it? If you had confidence from the infinite, you couldn't have lost it. Okay, if not today, tomorrow. If not tomorrow, day after. If not day after, after 1 year. कोई बात नहीं, आज हार गए, नेवर माइंड, अगेन आई विल ट्राई, अगेन माय प्रेयर विल बी देयर. हनुमान जी डिड नॉट गेट टायर्ड बिकॉज अनदर ही गॉट थर्स्टी. दीज मंकीज गॉट टायर्ड एंड थर्स्टी बिकॉज व्हेन भगवान वॉज सेंडिंग परसा सी सरोह पानी, भगवान राम पुट हिज हैंड ऑन द हेड ऑफ हनुमान जी, सो स्टिल ही फेल्ट देयर इज वन shade on my head. Experience of somebody's hand on my head is kripable. You cannot go alone in your life by your ahankar. And Hanuman ji had mudrika in his mouth. It had Ram Naam. He said, Ram Naam I have, so I'm not having thirst also. So when a person, so I told to that person, their self-confidence, please associate with the confidence of the God in that. Because qualifications don't help too much. Arjun was very qualified and he broke in the battlefield. Tam tatha kripyavishtam Ashrupurna Kulekshanam. So he started crying almost. But because he had faith in the Lord, he regained it by saying, Karpanya Doshopatasvabhava Prachami Tvam Dharma Sammodacheta. He got back his confidence. So life will try to break my confidence. Here is where our faith system comes to protect us. So when a person has done prano upasana or ishvaro upasana, he doesn't give up in doing something right. There is nothing called I have lost all hopes. There is nothing called all I see darkness. I have reached the dead end. Okay. And God will verify that. So now let me see the next upasana in 23rd and 24th. So Vakpatitva upasana we saw yesterday. He is the pati of all speech and all Vedas. Okay. Now it is for you to consolidate it in your mind. The topic, how the topic has built up. That we had three brahmanas, three upasana was there, Ashvopasana, Agni Upasana, Prana Upasana. In Prana also, Guna Vishisht Prana Upasana. Lot of gunas were there. Now next Upasana, 23rd and 24th is called Udgit Upasana. Udgitha. So please repeat after me. Page 145. Esha Uva. Udgitha. प्राणोवा उत्प्राणेन हीदं सर्वं उत्तब्धं वागेव गीतोच्च गीताच्च इति स उद्गीतः. Next page. Taddhapi Brahmadattah Chaikitano ye Chaikitaneyo Rajanam Bhakshayan Uvacha Ayam Tyasya राजा मूर्धानं विपातयात् यदितो आयास्य आंगिरसः अन्येदो नद अगायत इति वाचच एव स प्राणेन चोद्गायत इति. See, it is written here, Pran is nothing but Udgita. So, Udgitatvam of Prana. This is the next guna of the Prana. Udgitatvam. Let me revise first. Vishuddhatvam. Second word. Duratvam. Third. Bhartritvam. Fourth. Angirasatvam. Vakpatitvam. And now Udgitatvam. I hope I have not missed anything. How many? Sixth. Okay. So Udgit word. Amma was asking one day about Udgit word. So Udgit originally Omkar occurring in Samaveda is called Udgita. Technically. Omkar occurring in Samaveda. By Ud means what? Ut, high pitch. So high pitch is called Ut. Ut word means high pitch. So here it is said Pran alone is the Udgita. So Udgita, high pitch supported by Vak. So Vak Uparjana is Udgita. So high pitch Omkar chanting requires Pran and Vak. So Pran and Vak. So Vak is Om Shabda and Sam is Omkar chanting. So you need Om, you raise that. So there is a Pran aspect when you say, and second is the Ud means Pran Swarupam and Geet means Vak Swarupam. I am summarizing. Ud means Pran Swarupam. Where you chant loudly, Om, like that. And in that you need a Vak. You need Vak also. You need a speech. A person who is dumb, he can't chant. He will have Bal. He has Pran, but no Vak. Yesterday also I had touched upon that topic. So you need Ud. Ud means Pran Swarupam and Geetha. Geet ka hi Geet hai. Like Geet is there, Geetha. Geet means Vak Swarupam. So Pran plus Vak, that is called the Udgita. Okay. Achha, among Pran and Vak, I had told also, Pran is important. Because Vak is also supported by the Pran only. Okay. So Eshahuva Udgita. So that Om chanting that you do, that also has Ishwar Tattva. And therefore Om is very important. Therefore, all mantras are preceded by Om Sahana Bhavatu, Om Trimbakam, Om Bhadram Karanibhi. Because Om is a mantra. What did Maharshi Panini say about Om? Tasya Vachakaha. Next. Good. Tasya Vachakaha Pranava. The Pranav word in Sanskrit, Pranav Ganesh is there, no? Pranav. So generally they don't use the word Om because it is too pure. While walking, talking, they don't use the word Om unless your mouth and body is pure. So Om and Pranav in Sanskrit, it has come from Nu Dhatu. Prakarshena Nuyate Anin Iti Pranava. Through which you praise somebody a lot. So therefore Maharshi Patanjali, he said, Tasya Vachakaha Pranava, Tasya Ishwarasya. Of that Ishwar, how do you address the Ishwar? Well, his name is Pranava. Om. Then what shall we do? Tajjapaha. You do the japa of that. tadarth bhavanam, and you contemplate on the meaning of that pranavaha. Because he said the Ishwar is sarvesham api guru kalen anavachedat. So he says that Ishwar is the first guru. Okay. So this om is very important. Om is very important. In Prashnopishad, there is a lot of description. So they say if you emphasize on so you will go after death, you will come back in the human birth, very exalted state of mind. Or if you pronounce oh, you will go to Swargalok. If you pronounce this is called Makar. Generally, only sannyasis pronounce that because it closes all activities. And there is a matra after two omkar, that is the Brahman there. So Makar chanting will go to Brahmalok. I'm just summarizing. And Panchadashikar in fourth chapter of Dvait Vivek, he says, Dirgha Pranam Uchcharya, if you are very disturbed, chant Om very loudly. Om. How many times? 10 times, 20, as much as disturbance is there. My disturbance will take the whole day. So never mind. You can chant that. So you can loudly chant Omkar. So Udgita, that Udgita, the bal in the Omkar is also of that prana. See, don't forget the main thing. Please don't read these mantras objectively. They are very serious matters. So that has to be subjectively read. So Esh, that means prana, Udgita. Now by that chanting, what happens? That the bal comes. Kathopnishad says, Etad Devaksharam Brahma, Etad Devaksharam Brahma, Etad Devaksharam Gyatva, Yo Yadichyasi Tasya Tat, Etad Alambanam Shrestham, Etad Alambanam Param, Etat alambanam jnatva brahma loke mahiyate. So this akshar, anything it can give you also of the world. Supposing you want knowledge. Here we want knowledge only. And we chant Omkar. So this Omkar has a rishi. You know who is the rishi of Omkar? Brahma. So that rishi will bring you knowledge also. These mantras are very powerful. Omkar. More is there, I will tell later on. Now he tells one anecdote. Anecdote, what is there? Next shloka you see. So, anecdote is there. Tadhapi brahmadatta chaikitana. Chaikitaneya. There is one person whose name is brahmadatta chaikitana. Chaikitana may be surname. So Brahmadatta Chaikitana. Achha. So he was doing yagya. And in that yagya, he drank one som. There is some liquid, that mantra, it has some mantra in it, that is called som. And he said in that particular yagya shala, that what mantra was being chanted was associated with prana and vak. So if this was chanted by, if it was devoid of power of prana, got my point? What I chanted, it had prana and vak. But if it was devoid of prana and vak, then the same liquid which I am drinking, let it sever my head. So, so this is called, you know, they take vows. This is the power of truth. Like Sita ji, when she walked on the fire, So what was the thought? Let all the time in my life, other than Bhagwan Ram, had not, if anybody, any Purush has come even for 1 second in my mind, 1 second also, then let me be burnt.
So power of truth was such
that the fire became cold as the sandalwood. Because sankalp shakti is there. There is some shakti called sankalp shakti in a person. So that devata of fire withdrew the heat. Because he is sakshi. In the marriage also, sakshi is the fire. Sakshi means one who witnesses everything. Because heat is there in my body also, in my mind also the heat is there. And heat is outside also, temperature is there. And therefore this fire is sakshi of all my outer action also and inner intention also. And this Som he is saying, this is just a praise of what? Udgita Upasana. This sort of sentence is a praise that Omkar Uchcharan is with the power of prana in it. It is with the power of prana shakti in it. That means that power of Hiranyagarbha and Ishwar is there in Omkar, which makes it give the big fruit to the chanter. And therefore you prefix it with all the mantras to get more bigger fruit. I hope this much is clear. Let me now go. So this was Udgitatva of prana. Okay. Now bal hai omkar mein. So much of strength is there. So much of Ishwar Shakti has been in omkar. So it is not just monosyllable word. Okay.